शीतलाभाय कर्म किं तन्न कथ्यते किं दम्पतिमिति ब्रूयाम् उदाहो दम्पति इति सॉरी या सुभद्रा भद्रासनम् अधितिष्ठन्तम् वी आर लुकिंग एट द सी द नेक्स्ट सेक्शन वी हैव टू गो इज अधिगम्य भगवन्तं पितामहम् दैट इज वेयर एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग टू गेट कनेक्टेड टू सो द देवास आर have gone to the Swayambhuva Bhavanam and they see Brahma sitting on the Bhadrasanam. And how is he? The rest is description of Brahma. And after approaching Brahma, Brihaspati spoke to him, started to speak something. That's where the paragraph ends. Can you start reading from that?
समुद्यत आदित्य सहस्र भास्वरै अर्केन्दु विद्युद अनल रूप चतुस्तेज समुत्तम्भनाय इव चतुर्दिक्षुः चतुर्दिक्षु निर्जिहानैः तेजोभिः अवलुम्पन्तमिव दिव्यमपि चक्षुर्दिवौकसां संसत
होल थिंग इज अगेन एन एडजेक्टिव टू ब्रह्मा हियर लेट्स गो वन बाय वन सो इट्स ईजियर दिवौकसां चक्षुः दिव्यमपि चक्षुः अवलुम्पन्तम् इव इट् वास् एस् इफ् ब्रह्मा वास् ट्रैङ्ग् टु अवलुम्पन्तम् हि वास् ट्रैङ्ग् टु कवर् द दिव्यचक्षुस् आफ् द देवास् सो वित् हिस् तेजस् वित् हिस् ब्रिलियन्स् इट् वास् एस् इफ् हि वास् ट्रैङ्ग् टु मेक् द देवास् क्लोस् देर् ऐस् अवलुम्पन्तं निमीलन्तम् So Nimilayantam. It was as if he was trying to close their eyes, even though it was a Divya Chakshu. So Animilita Lochanaha. They don't close their eyes at all. That is the identification of Devas, right? So Divaukasam, the Devas Divyamapi Chakshuhu, even though it was a divine eye that they had, Prakasha of Brahma was trying as if to close that eye of the Devas. So how is the Prakasha? Sama samaya samudyat aditya sahasra bhaswaraihi. Sama samaya. Ekasmin samaya eva sahasra adityaha are, you know, rising. There are, it is as if the 1,000 suns are rising at the same time. The prakasha has such a brilliance. And when all thousands of adityas are rising, because of that prakasha bhaswaraihi arka indu vidyut anala roopa chatus tejas samuttambanaya eva, as if to stop the four types of luminance, samuttambanam, to obstruct, in order to obstruct the four types of prakasha that is there in the world, which is arka, surya, indu, chandra, vidyut, lightning, anala, agni. Agni Rupa Chatus Teja Chatwari Tejamsi Tejam Samuttambanaya Iva, as if he wanted to obstruct the four types of Prakasha in all four directions. Chatur Dikshu Api Nirjihanaihi, the Prakasham was emanating from him. Nirjihanaihi Tejobihi Bahir Agachadbihi Tejobihi Saha. So the adjective for Tejas is sahasra aditya bhaswaraihi sama samaya udita. When at the same time, when thousands of suns are rising at the same time, his tejas is as brilliant as that, and it is emanating from his body. Nirjihanaihi nirbahir nirgachatihi tejobihi saha divaukasam divyamapi chakshuhu avalampantam eva. It is as if he is trying to close the divine eye of the devas. Next.
संतत व्यवहार व्यवहार संसत्त संसत्त त्रिचतुर राग
आगम अक्षर
त्रिचतुर आगम आगम अक्षर प्रेक्षणीय ప్రేక్షణీయద్ అంత చంద్రికా వికాస పరిహృత సంసార శార్వరైహి ఆయాత ఆయతాపాంగ
రింగత్
రింగత్ అభంగ
అభంగుర
అభంగుర అభంగుర కరుణా తరంగ మాలాభిహి ఆచార్యకాభిహి ఆచార్యక అభిషేక అభిషేక అభిషేక
ఆదదానైహి
అభిషేకం ఆదధానైహి ఇవ యోగినాం అధ్యాత్మ విద్యాసు
there is a comma there so yoginam adhyatma vidyasu he now all of now these are going to be an adjective for his four faces now let's look at the next page I will show you where it is so chatasranam api shrutinam anana pankajaihi anugrinnantam abitaha mahashayan that is where we are going to come and connect it okay anana pankajaihi in tritiya bahuvachanam so anana pankajaihi with the lotus face with the four faces of his with his four faces which are like lotuses he is mahashayana mahabhagana those who are all sitting those great people who are sitting close to him it is as if he is doing anugraha for them anugrahantam iva abitaha api even though they are close by it is as if he is gracing them with all, gracing all the fortunate ones mahashayaha mahabhagyashalinaha so anana pankajaihi now where does it start here santata vyavahara all his with his mouth he is constantly saying the vedas so the vedas are supposed to reside in his mouth so santata vyavahara samsakta because it is constantly being సతత ఉచ్చారణ వ్యవహార సామర్థ్యాత్ బికాస్ హీ ఈస్ కాన్స్టెంట్లీ సేయింగ్ ఇట్ లౌడ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ యాజ్ ఇఫ్ దట్ ఆగమ అక్షర త్రీ ఆర్ ఫోర్ ఆర్ ఆల్వేస్ స్టక్ అండ్ వీ కెన్ సీ ఇట్ ఇన్ బిట్వీన్ ఓకే సో సంతత వ్యవహార సంసక్త బికాస్ ఆఫ్ కాన్స్టెంట్లీ సేయింగ్ దట్ వేదాస్ It is the three chatura agama akshara. Agama akshara, three or four agama aksharas can be seen, which is always present inside his mouth. Now, how is that? It is seen through as prekshaniya danta chandrika vikasa. By the blooming of the teeth, you know, that prakasha from the teeth that is there, you can see through that. So he is smiling or he is constantly saying it also so when you open the mouth through the interval that is there between the dantam you can easily figure out the agama akshara that is there inside his mouth even that is enough for removing the tamas of the samsara so samsara sharvaraihi sharvara you can say sharvaram is andha tamaha or the gaadha andhakaram is sharvaram tamaha so tamash samsara sharvaraihi samsara sharvaram the tamas associated with the samsara this world that is janma punarjanma that is parihritam that is removed by the vikasa by the increase of chandrika the moonlight that comes in the form of the danta prakasha danta chandrika the moonlight that comes from the dantam through which prekshaniyam you can identify three chatura agama three or four agama akshara three or four letters of the veda which is all constantly present in his mouth because he is saying it okay now his four faces are like this it is capable of removing the tamah prakata tamas associated with samsara next ayata apanga rinkat abangura karuna taranga malabihi the face also has an ayata apangam his apangam the corner of his eyes is also very ayatam dirgham and there his karuna tarangam he is full of grace and he is showering his karuna taranga malabihi it has the waves of karuna is coming in form of waves from his apanga in his face. Tadrisha mukha yuktaha saha. So the anana pankacham, it is an adjective for the anana pankacham, right? So tarangamala, karuna tarangamala yuktabihi anana pankajaihi. What is he doing with that karuna tarangam? Acharya abhishekam karoti iva. Yoginam acharya abhishekam adadanaihi iva. It is as if he is doing acharya abhishekam for yogi who are constantly in the adhyatma vidya. Acharya Abhishekam is, it is usually performed by the Shivacharya Kulam. Those who are all, they do not, unless they have the Acharya Abhisheka done to them, they can do not have the rights to approach the God and do puja for them. So those Shivacharyas, by nature, they have that, even if they have the studies and everything, they cannot approach the God and do puja. So the Acharya Abhishekam has to be performed. And once you do the Acharya Abhishekam, there are a lot of niyamas that you have to follow with that, after that. So here he says, in Adhyatma Vidya, for yogis, it is as if he is doing the Acharya Abhishekam for the yogi, for the sages, with his faces. With the Karuna Tarangam that comes from Karuna Jalam that comes from his Apangam, which is capable of removing the samsara. The Danta Prakasha is capable of removing the samsara tamas. You get the idea now? Next.
Akka, what is Ringad Bihi? I'm sorry.
Rinkat, apanga rinkat is it is pravahanti. It's flowing from the apanga.
Rinkati.
Huh?
Kriya padam is rinkati, va?
Ringati. Ringati atava rinkati. Rinkhanna, rinkati, rinkhanna atava ringat, ringati.
Oh, that is never heard of, like ringati. It is like
absolutely. Also, it also will come in rinkhat, will come as bhramara rinkhanam for bees. The humming of the bees is called rinkhat. Here, ringat is pravaha. So, ayata dirgha apangebhyaha ringantyaha karunataranga malaha.
Astu. Chaturbihi iva antapuraihi daitanam chetasrunam api shrutinam anana pankajaihi anugruhnantam abhito api mahashayan.
Okay, so chatasrinam api shrutinam chaturbihi iva antapuraihi daitanam antapuraihi iva. These four Vedas, each head of Brahma is supposed to be a representation of the Veda, one Veda. Veda, the Vedasya Anyanama Shruti. Shruti is in Strilingam. Vedaha is in Pullinga, whereas Shruti is in Strilingam. So he uses that Linga Samyam and says, Chaturbihi Daitanam Chaturbihi Antapuraihi Iva. As if it is the Antapuram for his beloved. The four faces are like the Antapura for his beloved, which is the four Vedas. Chatasrinam api shrutinam daitanam antapuraihi iva chaturbihi anana pankajaihi. It's as if like a residing place, antapura, like the quarters for shruti, for the Vedas, the four Vedas. Anana pankajaihi, with his four faces, he is mahashayana anugrinhantam abitaha api. On all sides around him, he was showering his anugraha for all the fortunate people.
Trayambaka mukutavalokana avalambita hamsa darshita hamsa dasharjitena mrunala valayeneva mriduna shuchina cha sutramayena upavitena suchayantam iva sutratmakatatmanaha
Stop with that. So sutratmakatam atmanaha. Atmanaha sutratmakatam suchayantam iva. It was like he was showing himself to be the sutratma. Sutratma is a very technical term where it is Ishwara Tattva. He is called sutratma. He is given some in the Vyakhyanam. I was just trying to look at that. See, not this. Sutratmani dehe yasya bhavaha tatta. Atmanaha swasya sutratmani athava linga sharire. Linga sharira samashti abhimani ishwarasya sutratma samgyakatam. Ishwara tattva. So sutratma means ishwara tattvam as a technical term. So he wants to show that he is Ishwara Tattvam and not Parabrahma Swarupam. See, Maya Shabalitam becomes a Ishwara. When Parabrahma Swarupam gets associated with Maya, that is when you have Shiva, Sattva Pradhanaha, Rajav Pradhanaha, Tamav Pradhanaha. So you have three different Ishwara Tattvams there. And he wants to show himself off as the Sutratmakatam Atmanaha Sutratmakatam Suchayantam Iva. In order to indicate his being an Ishwara Tattva, he has an Upavitam, has his Yajnopavitam Sutramayena, which is made of a thread. Here that thread and there the Sutratmaka is the how he is the thread which connects the Jagat and the Parabrahma Swarupam, and that is why the Ishwara Tattvam is called the Sutratmaka. When just the Parabrahma Swarupam is existing, it is just a Jada Swarupam. You cannot have Prakriti. Unless Prakriti is there, you cannot have the creation or any activity in that Swarupa. Only when the Prakriti comes, then there is a relationship between that. When the Prakriti is attached to it, then it is called the Ishwara Tattvam, and that Ishwara Tattvam acts as a thread which connects the Jagat, the Jivan and the Brahma Swarupa. That is one way of explaining that he is. Or for a Jiva, when he gets associated with Maya and he moves from one Sharira to another as a Sutram. Sutram is a connector. That Linga Shariram acts as a connecting factor for him when he moves from one pocket to another, or one Shariram to another Shariram. So as a Jiva, he is also called a Sutratmaka, where he is Linga Sharira Vishishtaha. Linga Shariram is the complex of Jiva or the Atma with 17 other items called the Pancha Indriyam, Pancha Karmendriyam, Pancha Prana, Manas, Buddhi Manas. I think I'm correct. So that is also a Sutratmaka. So Linga Sharira as far as Jiva goes, and Ishwara Tattvam as far as the Parabrahma Tattvam goes. Okay. With his Yajnopavitam, he was showing that. How is that Yajnopavitam? Everything else is in Tritiya Vibhakti as an adjective for the Upavita. Upavita is Sutramayena. It is made of thread. Shuchina, pure. Mriduna, very soft. Mrinala Valayena, eva. It is like a lotus stalk, which is like very soft lotus stalk. And how it has earned the state of, like, imagine, you know, from Shiva's Makutam. He is such a Shiva Bhakta that he has to mention that. Trayambaka Makuta Avalokana Avalambita Hamsadasha Arjitena. It is like a row of swans which are standing on top of each other in order to look at Shiva's Makutam. Trayambakasya Makuta Avalokanaya Avalambita. Those who are hanging down. Or you can say they are standing on top of each other. One is attached to another, Hamsa. So I was imagining this, how it could be, what was going on in Nilakanta Dikshita's mind when he was, you know, describing this scene like this. I could only think of Megha Sandesham, where he says, you know, Bahyodhyana Stita Harashiras Chandrika Dhaudharamya. If you look at Amaravati, it is the walls of Amaravati has been rendered white because in its garden, Bahya Udhyana Sthita Hara Shiraha, Shivaha Bahya Udhyane Asti. Tasya Shirasi Chandraha. So from there, you, the rays are making the walls of Amaravati white. So if you imagine the Rajahamsas in the Himavat Parvatam, they all know that Shiva is in this place in Kailasam. They want to try to look at his Makutam. If they are trying to look at, you know, imagine a set of boys who are trying to, you know, look into the neighbor's compound and they stand on top of each other and try to look at it. It's like that image comes into your mind. So Trayambaka Makuta Avalokana Avalambita, in order to look at the Shiva's Makutam, the Hamsa is hanging. This Mrinala Sutram, this Yajnopavitam is resembling that Hamsa. So Hamsa Dasha Arjitena, it is as if it has earned the status of a row of swans which are hanging in order to see Shiva's Makutam. Trayambaka Makuta Avalokana Avalambita Hamsa Dasha Arjitena Mrinala Valayena Iva. Okay, next.
Akka, I did not quite understand that sutratmakata atmanaha. Why that sutratmakata atmanaha?
Okay, atmanaha sutratmakatam suchayantam eva. It's, he is indicating that he is an Ishvara Tattva. Or the other name for Ishvara Tattva is sutratmakam. Sutratmaka is where he is associated with that sutratmani. Deham is sutra.
Oh.
Okay. Because that, that there is a, how do I say that?
What does that mean?
Okay. Atmanaha swasya sutram atmani dehe. So swasya sutram, swasya atma. Sutram is atma. Sutratma is sutram atmani or dehe. The problem is atma can be defined as manas in one place. It will be said as deham in one place. It will be said as the atma swarupa or the soul in another place. You have to understand it in that manner. So here the first sutram means it is the atma. The next atma is actually the deham. So the fact that the atma resides in a deha, that is the sutratmata. The quality of residing in a deham and not as a paranjyotis swarupa.
Is sutratma.
Sutratma, yes. That's why I kept saying Ishvara Tattvam.
Oh, okay.
So Ishvara Tattvam, the when you understand paranjyotis swarupa, right? Which is the Atma Swarupa, which is Brahman. Okay. Now, there is only one according to Advaita where you only have the Parabrahma Swarupa. Now, what is the concept of Ishvara here? You have a form there. You are talking of four faces. You are talking of, you know, Prakasham. He is sitting on somewhere and all that. So, that Ishvara Tattvam comes up only when the Brahma Swarupa gets associated with something called Maya. That Maya gives him the body, which is his Deham. So when the Atma starts residing inside a body, it is called Sutratma.
Hmm.
The Atma is the Sutram because it goes as a thread from one Deham to another Deham.
Hmm.
And it can go, it has, in a Jivatma, the Jivatma is also a Sutratma. In the sense here, what happens is, it is not only the Atma Swarupam which travels from one body to another body. It takes along the experiences that it gets from one body to another body. That is why we are in the state of being a jiva. Whereas Ishvara does not have that extra samskaram that is there from one body to another. He just exists in that body and we call him as Ishvara. That is a sutratma for Ishvara Tattva.
So here it is for Brahma.
Yes.
So here for him, it is just that the all this description that is going on for Brahma, we are only referring to that description as the Sutratma here.
Yes.
Okay.
Because we are only talking of him as an Ishvara, not as a Parabrahma Swarupa. I should not have confused with all the Linga Shariram. So just remove how it applies to Jiva. Just take what how it applies to Ishvara Tattva.
No, I'm getting confused actually with Ishvara Tattvam. So what is Ishvara, I mean, why Ishvara Tattvam here? So are we saying that...
it's equal to, it is just a synonym for Sutratma.
Ishvara Tattvam is
the word. Okay, he is using the word Sutratma instead of saying Ishvara because he wants to highlight the point that Yajnopavita is made with Sutra so that he can get that double meaning here.
Okay, okay.
That's all. So Sutratma is equal to Ishvara Tattvam. The word Sutratma, what is the vyutpatti of it? Sutram is Atmanaha Sutra. Atma is equal to Sutram. Atmani dehe vartate. So tad bhavaha. Yasya dehe atma vartate. Tasya bhavaha. That is sutratmata. Just like sundarasya bhavaha, sundarata, that way.
I mean, here in the description, we are imagining that Brahma has a shariram and everything, like he has a sutram and everything. But that is not there, right? He is also, he's one of the Trinity. We cannot say that he has a shariram, right? So
he has a different shariram. His shariram is not the shariram that we see here. He has four pieces. We describe him with shariram and everything because a formless God is difficult for people to grasp in their mind and pursue for meditation or anything. So we try to attribute forms to him. Saguna Upasana, that is called Saguna Upasana.
Oh.
Without a form, it is very difficult for people to just say, you know, Jyoti, it's only that light that I think about. It's not easy for people, common people, to understand that Jyoti Swarupam and try to do meditation or Upasana for that. That's why we need forms. That's why we have a Shiva, Vishnu. There are so many different forms. Whichever is appealing for you, you can take that.
Okay.
That form is a shariram, and that shariram is not a shiryate iti shariram. Shiryate means that which destroys or that which becomes slowly, it starts a destruction process. That is your shiryate iti shariram. That is not the sharira that he has. You only say rupa.
Okay, Akka, thank you.
No, this is one. Without Advaita background, it's tough to get his the import of what he is trying to say.
I still have questions, but I think for now we have to stop here because otherwise.
It'll become a different discussion. Slowly, we can do that.
Yeah.
He has achieved the idea of what a Kavyam should do. Kavyam should slowly take you to the Tattva Vichara. That's the idea of every Kavyam. Mm-hmm. You enjoy it and slowly you move, gravitate towards Shastra Vichara. Then you of course come back with that background in your mind and look at Kavyam in a different manner because you will find in such a beautiful and enjoyable manner he has given the Shastra in a very nice manner. It's like a sugar-coated paint. You want to take up Brahma Sutram and study, you won't understand, or even if you try to, you will feel it is a dry subject. Now with this background, it's maybe not a bad idea to study some basic grantham in Vedanta. That's the way you will approach it, no?
Yeah.
To understand what is Sutratma, why that is, then you'll want to go for that.
Yeah. Thank you, Akka. Shastrastra Vidya Kupara.
Akupara Parina. It's actually Akupara.
Oh, Vidya Akupara Parina Kshatriya Varga Sarga Nirvrittataya Iva. Shastra Graha Parang Mukhena Pratrutyadi Prithivyanta Pancha Vimshati Tattva Parivartana Matram Eva Vyapara Iti ప్రదర్శయతేవ పాణినా దక్షిణేన పరివర్తయంతం
అక్షమాలికాం
అక్షమాలికాం
హి హాస్ అ యు నో దట్ తులసిమాల ఇన్ హిస్ అక్షమాల ఇన్ హిస్ హ్యాండ్ అండ్ హి ఇస్ కాన్స్టెంట్లీ పరివర్తయంతం హి ఇస్ రోలింగ్ ఇట్ ఇన్ హిస్ హ్యాండ్ ఇన్ హిస్ రైట్ హ్యాండ్ పాణిన దక్షిణేన పాణిన అక్షమాలికాం పరివర్తయంతం అధిగమ్య అప్రోచింగ్ బ్రహ్మ హూ వాస్ స్లోలీ రోలింగ్ దట్ అక్షమాల విత్ హిస్ రైట్ హ్యాండ్ వాట్ ఈస్ హీ డూయింగ్ విత్ దట్ ఇట్స్ ఇట్స్ అ స్మాల్ నైస్ ఇమేజరీ దట్ ఈస్ శస్త్ర అస్త్ర విద్యా అకూపార పారేణ క్షత్రియవర్గ సర్గ నిర్వృతతయా ఇవ is showing this whole world has only 25 tattvams. Sankhya system philosophy says that there are only 25, there are 25 tattvas in this world, or the whole world is made up of 25 elements. Prithivyanta prakrityadi prithivyanta panchavinshati tattva parivartana matrameva vyaparaha. My work, that is Brahma, it is as if Brahma is showing, pradarshayata iva panina, Brahma is showing with his right hand that, see, my work is vyaparaha. What is my work? Parivartana matrameva. My work is only to transform the 25 different tattvas that are present in this world. The creation, every system of philosophy, every darshanam starts off with how the world is created. They have to explain their method of creation here. In that, Sankhya Karika follows, which is followed by even Advaiti there. He says, prakrityadi, prakriti, then you have mahat, buddhi tattvam, then pancha indriyam, pancha karmendriyam, jnanendriyam. They have a set of items, pancha bhuta, prithivyanta. So, prakrityadi prithivyanta panchavimshati tattvam. There are 25 different tattvas, which parivartanam, the transformation of which is the entire creation of the world. That is only my vyapara. Iti pradarshayata iva panina. Now, why does he say that this is only my work now? I have no interest in taking up weapons. Shastragraha parangmukhena. It's... He has turned his face away from carrying any weapon. If you look at Shiva, he has a trishulam in his hand. He has a weapon. Vishnu has chakram, gada, panihi. Shankha chakra, gada, panihi. You have a chakram, you have a gada. He is displaying so many weapons. Whereas Brahma, he does not display any weapon. So, shastragraha parangmukhena. As if he is averse to carrying any weapons. Why is he averse? He says, I am very satisfied after creating the entire Kshatriya race. Shastra Astra Vidya Akubara Parina. The Kshatriya Varga Nirvritataya, as if he is happy. Nirvrita Sukha Sukhitaha Iva. Because he's very happy after Sarga creating the Kshatriya Varga, Kshatriya race, which have crossed the ocean of Shastra Vidya. Shastra and Astra Vidya. Akupara is Sagaram. Kupara means, actually, Ku is Prithivi. Prithivi, Prithivim Purayati iti Kupara. So, actually, Kupara is a small Kupam or a Gartam. If you have a small hole and bilam where the water comes and fills, that is called akupara. Akupara means it is sagaram, that which is not part of the earth, but it is outside of the earth. So the earth is supposed to be surrounded by the oceans. So akupara is the sagaram. Sagara, what is like a sagaram here? Shastra astra vidya eva sagara hatra. Shastra is normal weapons. Astram is mantra purvaka. Shastram is astram. So, astra vidya eva sagaraha tasya parangataha kshatriya varga. Parinaha, parinaha parangataha kshatriya vargasya sargena nirvritataya sukhitaya iva shastra graha para. I have done my creation. enough of this creating this Kshatriya Varga, which have just crossed the ocean of that Vidya, Shastra Vidya. And so it's as if he is averse to taking weapons in his hand. So now what is his job? Prakrityadi prithivyanta panchavimshati tattva parivartana matrameva vyaparaha. That is my only vyaparam or kriya. Iti pradarshayata iva. As if to show that he is rolling parivartayantam. That parivartanam is your connection between that prithivyadi panchavimshati and this parivartana. He is rolling or just moving the akshamala in his hand to show that everything is just a different transformation of these 25 tattvas. Next.
Akshamalayla vandhu beads vandhu in the 25 times 2 or something andha maadhiri adnala 25 solraala.
Even if it is 25 times 2, it doesn't plus come. One. I tried that. I was thinking of all the combinations of math and everything. 25 times 4 are the 100. And the baki 8 enna pandrathu theriyala enakku. Illana purushanoda sendu sonna kuda, even if you say purusha is the one tattvam, which is so 26, that one is only again 4, no? So where I idu vanna enna na the தத்துவத்தினுடைய ஒரு மாறுதல்களை காண்பிப்பதற்காக கையில் அதை மாத்திக்கொண்டே இருக்கிறார்.
So the matha parivartanathla na and the emphasis. Aama. Okay. Not the akshamala. Okay.
No, not the akshamala. So it is that parivartanam which is the connection between the two. அது தான் சொன்னேன். அகர்முகேஷு
அகர்முகேஷு பிரதமம் அபாமேவ ஸ்ரஷ்டவ்யதாம் அவதாரிய தார்யமானேன இவ ஸ்பட்டிகமயேன கமண்டலுனா பரிஷ்கிருத இதர கர பல்லவம்
இதர கர பல்லவம் ஹிஸ் அதர் ஹேண்ட் பரிஷ்கிருதம் அலங்கிருதம் கமண்டலுனா அலங்கிருதம் ஆசீத் இதர கர பல்லவம் ஹவு இஸ் தட் கமண்டலு ஸ்பட்டிகமயம் Spatikamayena, made of spatika. It's as if to show Pradhamam Abameva Srashtavyatam Avadharya. Kamandalu is filled with water, right? Aharmukheshu. Aharmukheshu means Pratyushakale. During dawn, the first thing that has to be created is Pradhamam Abameva Srashtavyatam. That is the first thing that has to be created. In order to show that water is the first creation, he has a kamandalu in his hand. It is as if. So these are all utpreksha here.
Idana and the yasrishti la vardhu.
Ah.
Adhya srishti.
Chandogya. Yeah, Chandogya la vandhu, the first thing they say is, water was the first thing that was created. Many people say prithivi, appu, tejo, vayu, akasha. So the prithivi is the first creation or akasham is the first creation. But in Chandogyam, he says appu is the first creation. And Shakuntalam also, he starts off with ya srishtihi srashtuhu adhya srishtihi. That which is Brahma's first creation is up or water. Apam yeva srashtavyatam avadharya. That water is the first thing that has to be created in the morning. That so Brahma's morning is the start of a kalpam. So it is the start of a creation. That is his morning. At every morning he has to create. So whereas for us it will go on. No, Brahma Ahar Divasam is for one Brahma's day is so many thousands of years for us. Right? So the creation starts off when it is Pratyushakalam for Brahma. Another way to look at it is also, see, the first thing in the morning you discover when you get out is the dew or the water force that you see, right? You may see many things, but the dew is the first thing that is created in the morning, even before the sunlight comes up. So that is another very layman's understanding of how water is the first thing that is created. So Prathamam Apameva Srashtavyatam Avadharya, keeping in mind that Apameva, only water is the Prathamam, the first thing that Srashtavyata, that Srashtum Yogyam. So that is that which has to be first created, keeping that in mind, as if keeping that in mind, he has a Kamandalu in his other hand. Next.
Asakrit Adhita Adhyapita Nikhila Nigamanta సిద్ధాంత పాంథ సనక సనందన సనందనాది మహాదేశిక ఉద్భావిత దుర్భేద సంశయ సంశయ ఛేద ఛేద సంవాద జిజ్ఞాసయా ముహుర్ముహు అవలోక అవలోకయంతం అంతిక గతాం వాగ్దేవతాం.
Vagdevata is sitting beside him. Antikakatam Vagdevatam Muhurmuhu Avalokayantam. He is called, again and again Brahma is looking at Saraswati, who is sitting beside him. Antikakatam. Why is he doing that? Jignasaya, in order to know. Samvada, Samshayacheda. See, there is an argument that keeps going on between the rishis who are all sitting there. Asakrita, Adhita. They are constantly reading and teaching the Nikhila Nigamanta Siddhanta. Nigama, Nikhila, all the Nigama, Agama, Veda, Vedanta until the Upanishad. The Siddhanta that comes out of the Vedanta is your the philosophy, any darshanam that is there. So that pantha, the process of understanding the Siddhanta or the philosophy that is there in the entire Upanishads. That process, they are constantly studying and teaching. Asakrita adhita swayam patanti tatha అన్యేభ్యః పాఠయంతి చ. సో పరేభ్యః అధ్యాపయంతి. సో అసకృత్ అధీత అధ్యాపిత నిఖిల నిగమాంత ఉపనిషత్ ఉపనిషదాం సిద్ధాంత పాంథే ప్రవర్తమాన సనక సనందనాదయః. సో సనక అండ్ సనందన ఆర్ ది రిషీస్ హూ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ ఇన్ దట్ పాత్ సంచరణశీలాః. పాంథః ఇస్ యాక్చువల్లీ అ ట్రావెలర్. ది ట్రావెలర్స్ Sanaka, Sanandana, that's the literal meaning there. So the travelers means one who is accustomed to going. Otherwise, he is not a pantha. Panthaha is not a person who is the first time traveler. So these people have gone in that path so many times. So Sanaka, Sanandanaadi, Mahadeshika, Darshayati, iti Deshikaha, one who shows us the path. So these rishis are like Deshika for us. Udbhavita, now even though they have constantly studied the Vedas, they have a lot of Durbeda, Samshayacheda, Samvada. They have arguments based for to understand the things which are Durbheda, which is difficult to understand, and Samshayacheda, the arguments which are capable of removing doubts and removing Durbeda Cheda and Samshayacheda. You can either understand something wrongly or you have a doubt about it. Doubt is always two things, whether it is this or that. Or is it, if someone says, you know, is Samshaya, or if I say Mahadeshika means a bad person. That is a Durbhedam. That is a wrong understanding. So Samshaya is a doubt and Durbheda is a wrong understanding. Or you can say Dukkena Bedhyate, to understand. Difficult to understand. The Samshaya which is difficult to remove, you can use that as an adjective for the samshaya also. Durvedaha samshayaha tesham chedanam. Which does the chedanam? Samvadaha. The guru-shishya samvada happens when you want to remove the doubt which is very difficult to remove. Durbheda, which is difficult to remove. Tadrisha samvaja jignasaya. When these conversations happen between them, in that vishaya, Brahma has a doubt. He wants to know. So when he wants to know, whom does he look at? He looks at Saraswati. So he again and again looks at Saraswati when these Sanaka and Sanandana are having conversations about doubts and how to remove it. You get it? So Asakrita, Adhita, Adhyapita, Nikila, Nigamanta, Siddhanta, Pantha, Sanaka, Sanandanadi, Mahadeshikaihi, ఉద్భావిత దుర్భేద సంశయచ్ఛేద సంవాదాః తస్మిన్ బ్రహ్మణః జిజ్ఞాసా వర్తతే తత్కారణాత్ ముహుర్ముహు సరస్వతీం పశ్యతి తాదృశం భగవంతం పితామహం. నెక్స్ట్.
ఆచార్యం ఆచార్యాణాం అధిగంతవ్యం అధిగంతవ్యానాం పరమానంద పరమానంద తుండిలమపి ప్రపన్నానుగ్రహై గ్రహై ओ प्रपन्नानु ग्रह एक व्यसनिनम समष्टिम भूतग्रामस्य साधारणम पितरम अखिल लोकस्य विश्रांति भूमिम विद्याफलानां विराम पदम वाग्भूतीनां वाग्विभूतीनां दूरं दुराशयानां अदूरं आत्मवेदिनां अधिगम्य भगवन्तं पितामहं.
That's where we have to, he approaches Bhagavantam Pitamaham, he approaches Brahma. After approaching Brahma, Samipam Agatya. How is he? Now what are all the other adjectives? Acharyanam Acharyaha. Saha. Is the teacher among all teachers? Adigantavyam Adigantavyanam. If there are something that we have to achieve in our life, he is the prime thing that has to be achieved. He is the one that has to be known. Another, you have to look at Upanishads here. Esya vijnanena sarvam vijnatam bhavati tad vijignasasva tad brahma. Not Brahma, but Brahma. For Brahma Swarupam, we say, when you know one thing, then everything else is known. You cannot go to each and every corner of the world and try to understand each and every object that is there in the world. You cannot. But we say that the Brahma Swarupam is the thing. If we understand that, then everything else becomes known for us. That is, Eka Vijnanena Sarvam Vijnatam Bhavati. He is that Ishvara Tattvam, which is the representation of that Brahma Swarupa. So, Adhigantavyam, Adhigantavyanam, Brahma Eva, Adhigantavyam Asti, Praptavyam Asti. Paramananda Tundilamapi, Prapanna Anugraha Eka Vyasaninam, Paramananda Tundilam. If you are extremely satisfied and happy, you don't have to make any effort to do anything in this world. Everybody looks for Sukham in this world. But once you have attained that sukham, would you keep on doing some activity in this world? No, you won't. Whereas Brahma is different. Paramananda Tundilam api. Tundilam, we usually use that word for Ganapati. Tundilaha is a person who is very fat. So Paramananda Tundilaha, Ananda Puritaha api Brahma, Prapanna Natanam Anugraha Eka Vyasaninam. He is ever involved, he always exercises to give anugraham for vyasanaha. He makes an activity, karyam karoti, sada karyam karoti, ekameva karyam karoti, which is prapannanam anugraha eka vyasaninam. Tam, next, bhutagramasya samashti. Oh, this is another difficult thing. Samashti and vyashti. Samashti is collective, vyashti is particular. If you have vrikshaha, it is a vyashti. Vyashti means it is a singular item. Vrikshaha, tree. A collection of tree, a collective of tree is a forest. So vanam is samashti. The same way each one, bhuta grama, living being is ekap, vyashti. Samashti is your Brahma Swarupa, which is Brahma here as an Ishvara Tattva representative. So, Bhutagramasya, he is the collective of all living beings. Like if you have one flower, you have many flowers, a collective of it is called a bouquet. In the same way, you have so many people and he is like a collective of it. Bhutagramasya samashtim, akhila lokasya sadharanam pitaram. He acts like a normal father to the entire world. The people who live in this world. Vidya phalanam vishranti bhumim. When a fruit comes, it falls down naturally and rests in the bhumi. He is like a resting place for the vidya phala, the fruit of knowledge. Vag vibhutinam viramapadam. The resting point or the stopping point of all words. That is vacham agocharam ityartha. I'm trying to describe Brahma. I can say he has four faces. I can say so many things. But after a point, there is a point where your speech stops. So vag vibhutinam, for the speech, the different types of speech stops at that point. You're not able to describe beyond that point. That is virama padam. Duram durashayanam. Dushta ashayaha yesham vidyate durashayaha. Those who have a wrong intent. He is far, he is unattainable by people who have the wrong intent. So durashayanam dure sthitaha. Kintu atmavedinam adure sthitaha samipeye vartate. Those who are seeking the knowledge of self, for him, he is extremely near. Which is swaswarupaha. That is your true nature. You understand that this Atma Swarupam that is there in Brahma and the Atma Swarupam that is there, he is here. He is ever present in you. That is why you say Atma Vedinam Yesham Atma Vidya those Parangataha Tesham Adure Vartate Samipeyeva Vartate, which is their own Atma. They understand that Jivatma and Brahmatma are the same. There's a Jivatma and Brahma Swarupam are the same. Paramatma are the same. Tadrisham Bhagavantam Pitamaham Adhigamya. Approaching him, he will start talking. Okay.
Brahma Vaidhiniya Matte Adhigantavyam Abdin Sora, like Brahma Padavi Alar Kuharno Anamatria.
Okay. Rendavidama Adhiklama. Brahma Padavi Varanona, to attain the position of Brahma, I don't think we need Neelakanta Deekshithar to say that.
புரியல எனக்கு ஏன் அவர்
சொல்றாங்க உபாசனா பேசிஸ் இஃப் யூ லுக் அட் இட் ஃப்ரம் தி உபாசனா ஆங்கிள் தென் எஸ் எவ்ரிபடி வாண்ட்ஸ் டு அட்டைன் ஸ்வர்கம் ஸோ ஆஃப்டர் தட் இட் யூ வாண்ட் டு கோ டு சத்தியலோகம் ரைட் தட் இஸ் அ நேச்சுரல் ப்ராசஸ் தட் பீப்புள் அண்டர் கோ தட் இஸ் தி உபாசனா பாத் இஃப் யூ டேக் த ஞான மார்க ஹீ இஸ் ஆல்சோ அந்த As I said, you know, in the Saguna Upasana, he is a representative of that, liya, and the Saguna Upasana. Anala namma vandu Ishwarana adayanonu paakkarche, Ishwaranude anugraham adayano. You can say Sayujyam, Salokyam, Samipyam, all those things as the goal for Saguna Upasana. Just as how you want to attain Salokam, Samipyam with Vishnu or Shiva, in the same way, Brahma is also a person to be attained at that point.
Oh. Huh?
Sorry. கொஞ்சம் அப்ட்ராக்டா இருக்கும்
இல்ல இல்ல இந்த சாயுஜியம்லாம் கேட்டா விஷ்ணு இல்ல மேபி சிவன் கொஞ்சம் யோசிக்கலாம் பட் பிரம்மாவை யோசிச்சேன் சரஸ்வதியை கூட யோசிச்சுடலாம் போலிருக்கு
சரஸ்வதி திருப்பி திருப்பி பாக்குற பிரம்மாவை நம்ம வந்து சாயுஜ்யம் சாலோக்கியம்னு நமக்கு வந்து தோணல இல்லையா ஆமா அது அங்கதான் யூ யூ திங்க் ஆஃப் தி கர்ஸ் தட் ஹஸ் கம் இன் டு ஃபோர்ஸ்ல தட் அடிமுடி தேடின கதா So Brahma does not have any temple, he's not worshipped. No, we can't even think of Sayujyam with Brahma. Zalokam with Brahma. We only think of Shiva and Vishnu there. Very different portrayal of everything. Language is very different. Yeah?